Yesterday, it was announced that President Biden would not be claiming executive privilege on the White House visitor logs from the day of the insurrection, January 6th, 2021. And those logs will, in fact, be turned over to the January 6th Select Committee. Now, the call logs from that day from the White House have also already been turned over. But unfortunately, they cannot find, as far as we know, what's been reported, any phone calls to or from Donald Trump from White House telephones that day. So, turning over the visitor logs, what exactly is that going to mean? You know, when this news was announced on Wednesday, by the way, lots of people celebrating online, saying, oh man, you're going to get them, this is it. I'm here to kind of throw a little bit of cold water on that, unfortunately. Is this a development? Sure. Is it an important development? Probably not. It's been a slow news week, and I think that's why this story really blew up. And I hate to say that, but let's be honest, that's what's going on here. There's not a whole hell of a lot new to talk about right now, so media outlets grasp onto any story they think might capture some headlines. And of course, this one sure did. So let's actually ponder for a minute, all right? Let's for a moment assume that this is significant, because it could be. I mean, don't get me wrong, it absolutely could be. I just am not so positive that it will be. So what could they be looking for? Obviously, they could be looking for whether or not Rudy Giuliani came into the White House that day to discuss plans to overturn the election. They could be looking at which members of Congress, if any, met with Donald Trump about turning over the election. Was MyPillow CEO Mike Lindell there? We know that he was a big part of this. We know that he held a little teleconference with everybody to explain to them how they were able to turn over the election. So yes, there are plenty of things that could be found within those visitor logs. However, the lack of evidence coming out kind of tells us that if we thought those people were there, somebody would have already said, yes, they were there. A Mike Lindell isn't the kind of guy that just slips in and out of the White House very easily. Neither is Rudy Giuliani. Somebody somewhere, if they saw them those days, probably would have already said something to the media. It would have been leaked. So that actually is why I don't think we're going to find anything too inflammatory in those visitor logs. I do, however, want to say that I am glad the Biden administration is turning them over. You know, during the Obama years, they voluntarily released their visitor logs on a monthly basis. President Biden has voluntarily done the same thing since he came to office. And that's good for the sake of transparency. Donald Trump obviously wanted to keep all of his things hidden. These visitor logs, by the way, from the day of January 6th, no different. He wanted to keep them hidden. And usually when this man wants to keep something hidden, it's because he has something he feels is worth hiding. So there may be a there, but it's one of those things we're going to have to wait and see what the committee says is actually in those visitor logs. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.